about NiKo, I mean, what can you say about him? I remember when he was a kid, when we were still playing, when 1.6 was still the game being played, and, you know, I was like, I don't know, let's say an up-and-coming player, like second or third best team in the country, and there was this kid coming in with his parents, like from Bosnia. He comes to the tournament, they have to come with him, and he has to bring all these books to put on the chair because he can't actually even sit properly behind the desk and play the game. And I remember, like, in the beginning, like, his passion was so insane. I think I deleted him from Steam like 15 times back then and everything, because every day, all the time, he would just be mix, like, you know, 5v5, 5v5, 5v5. It's just like so annoying. It was like, please just stop messaging me. I mean, when we started playing in iNation CSGO, he was 17, kinda, you know, like, so in these parts, like, that's, you know, people already have had, like, at least beers or something before. And when we went to our first international tournament in Vienna, like, albeit back then we were dirt poor, but, you know, we would have, like, we would walk around, have some drinks. And then later on, when, you know, I started working and he started playing for Mouse Sports, and then later on for FaZe, we did have times when we would, you know, go out and party and have some fun. But yeah, even not in the days when it was 1.6, you know, he couldn't really do it in front of his parents. He was way too young back then. But later on, when we started playing CSGO and everything, yeah, for sure. Here, like, the culture is, you know, that's why also I had a good connection with the MIBR guys. Like, our culture is similar to the Brazilian one in the sense of, like, people are super friendly. They're laid back, even when sometimes they shouldn't be as laid back. You know, they're very passionate, emotional, like, you know, we used to argue on the team, and then we would have good times and so on. There's a lot of highs and lows. It's not like, for example, I don't know, the Scandinavian region, right? People are all pretty, like, mellow, I guess, you know, like, they don't get too excited about stuff, or they don't get too frustrated. They just kind of play. We're a bit different. So when it comes to me and NiKo, sure, like, we had the conversations, we had our arguments too. I remember when we were supposed to start playing in CSGO together, there was something about, like, Assad told me, hey, just message him, like, on Facebook with this or something, he's not answering my phone. And I typed his name and nothing popped up. I was like, what's going on here? And then I tried, and I remember, like, I blocked him on Facebook, like, way back, because he was, like, annoying about something. So I just, like, blocked him on everything. But we've definitely had, like, our heated arguments and yelling, but it wasn't that much, to be honest. Like, on the team, it was, that happened more, like, me and Kassad had that with between ourselves a few times, more so with some of the other players. But NiKo, he was just always so talented, and, like, he was doing his job within the game. He wasn't being, like, toxic. It wasn't like that. He was just playing, and he was playing really well. So there was very few ways for you to get into an argument with him. So it's great to see him compete, kind of be one of the world's best players, you know. So remember him when he, like, had to put things on the chair so he could actually even reach the PC. That was kind of hilarious.
Thanks for watching. If you want more great content just like this, be sure to hit the subscribe button.